Meanwhile, they have people to the White House that literally talk about drugging women and raping them. And they have these people around their kids, and then the daughters are out twerking and everything at the concerts. But that's okay. Well, fine. But then don't sit there and judge Trump, who never claimed he was, you know, some perfect angel. Here is that clip.
This was not just a lewd conversation. This wasn't just locker room banter. This was a powerful individual speaking freely and openly about sexually predatory behavior and actually bragging about kissing and groping women, using language so obscene that many of us were worried about our children hearing it when we turn on the TV.
Hey, Trump never claimed to be an angel. Now, here's a clip of Madonna. We can play this. The other ones have too much cussing, and we're going to read some of the transcripts here with Gerald Celente, but he's absolutely right. We've got to put these videos together.
If you vote for Hillary Clinton, I will give you a blowjob. Okay?
So she says, if you vote for Hillary, I will give you oral sex. I mean, this is just the trashiness, these people. And then this trash. At least she's not talking about raping women like the rappers do. This trash then points their finger at Trump in some edited secret recording. I guess that's what's got you so hot, because I know you're not a big Trump supporter. You're just pointing out the hypocrisy, Gerald.
Yes, and the hypocrisy of Michelle Obama. As I said, both her and her husband are disgusting frauds. You know Michelle's line, and you know Barack's line. When they go low, we go high. How low can they go? Hey, maybe the high they're talking about is all these rappers coming in there. Yeah, they may really get high. You cannot get lower than the people that Barack Obama and Michelle Obama have invited into We the People's White House. These low-life, disgusting people talking about getting women drugged out, getting them drunk and having sex with them, bragging how many women they could get at one time, and if you bring your friends over here, I'll do them to them too. One dirty piece of language after another coming from the mouths of the people that Barack Obama and, better than now, Michelle Obama invite to the White House. And bragging. Doing the dancing with them, and of course, Michelle shooting her mouth off all over the country. How loving fathers.
Well, then there's the thing about Hillary that basically harasses women and makes them have sex with her. That's well known. That's now coming out.
When you're talking about Trump's dirty language, you hypocrite. And all you little prostitutes out there, you little Anderson Coopers. All of you little nobodies out there with big mouths that won't repeat these words or call out the Obamas for what lying, freaking frauds they are to invite this scum into We the People's House.
And I'm really glad that he apologized. And I think when somebody seeks mercy and forgiveness and means it, and I was with him the entire time, including when he learned of this, then people ought to think about that. They ought to think about when somebody asks you for forgiveness and right. is contrite.
But and then, for people out of the workforce, 12.4 million
women without health, you don't want to cover it now. You want to talk over it. You don't even want to cover it now. You don't want to hear that there are over 16 million women in poverty on President Obama's watch. And Hillary Clinton, who's been fighting for women and children for 30 years, where is the deliverable? Where is the...
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for Anderson Cooper.
So don't fall in love with the notion that there are secrets being held from the American people.
Each evening's unapologetic bitch, a very special prize, right? Where is it, guys? It's a banana! Now, I'm sure you'll figure out what to do with it. And Keish here is going to help you He's going to take you down to the waiting ambulance, all right? Because, you know, we might do something dangerous with that banana. So goodbye, Anderson. Yeah, start right now, baby.
If you vote for Hillary Clinton, I will give you a blowjob, okay?
Because Hillary is also bisexual, leaning more towards a homosexual end.
And that was true before we heard him talking about...
As everyday locker room talk is an insult to decent men who are sickened by the thought of their daughters being exposed to this kind of vicious language about women.
So don't fall in love with the notion that there are secrets being held from the American people.
But this is Alinsky 101. It's been used by the left for decades. Accuse your opponents of something you yourself are guilty of. Keep them on the defense, and then that way they can never build an offense to attack you. Now, let's just kind of a little history lesson here. Who is Saul Alinsky? He is considered to be the guru of all community organizers, and he actually developed the organizational manual for aspiring Marxist revolutionaries here in the U.S., the infamous Rules for Radicals. So this is kind of the agitprop or agitators propagandist technique. So this has been used by the left in inner cities. It's also used on college campuses. We know that Hillary Clinton actually did her senior thesis on Alinsky. Obama was really fond of his teachings. A lot of people said his 2008 presidential campaign was influenced by Alinsky's teachings. And of course, a lot of internet trolls use Saul Alinsky's tactics. So these are the 13 rules for radicals, which, by the way, let's just back it up a little bit. He actually dedicated this book, Rules for Radicals, to Lucifer. To Lucifer. Yes, there in the book, it's dedicated to Lucifer. Dedicated to Lucifer, who he says is the original radical who rebelled against the establishment and gained a whole kingdom. So that's just to give you a little idea of who this Alinsky is and why the left idolize him, I guess. But if you look at rule number 11, if you push a negative hard and deep enough, it will break through into its counterside. So the winner in politics is almost always whoever is on offense. So if you make your opponent spend all their time refuting charges that they're extremists, racist, they hate women, they despise the poor, that means they are losing. And that's why Trump's always winning, because he's always going on the attack. He doesn't fall for that PC BS, and he calls them out on it, just like he did Dana Bash. So this is what they hope to do, is if they're always constantly accusing you of things, you don't have time to go after them. So that's why we see things like this WikiLeaks, where we're finding out now that it was actually the Clinton team who leaked the creeper shot of Bernie Sanders in his swimsuit. And this was something that they were going to do to try to accuse Bernie Sanders of being lazy. He was just lazing about in the Hamptons, taking money from Wall Street, which we know Hillary Clinton is the number one recipient of Wall Street money. And let's not forget that she was the one who didn't bother to visit any of the flood victims, because she was fundraising in the Hamptons with Cher. So she's accusing Bernie Sanders of something she herself is guilty of. We also know that Donald Trump was not afraid to point out the fact that Bill Clinton is rapey, and he's a sexual assaulter, and Hillary Clinton set the standards for what's okay for the president to do while he's in the White House. So the fact that he actually went after Bill Clinton, well, then so they got to go in their Alinsky handbook and, you know, we're going to accuse you of being a sexual assaulter, Donald Trump. It doesn't matter if it's true or not, because a lot of people will just think, well, if there's smoke, there's fire, and they'll believe those charges. This is right there, rule number 11. This is the tactic. So we know that leaked emails, Hillary Clinton's own campaign, her own staffers were struggling to deal with William J. Clinton's issues and trying to kind of prep Hillary Clinton to have to deal with a lot of this backlash. We also know that Hillary Clinton tried to come out accusing Donald Trump of the whole birtherism, saying that Trump's birther claims were based on racism. But that's, of course, been debunked, because she and her campaign were actually the ones who started the whole birtherism. They put out the picture of Obama in Somali garb. They were really working on how to expose and exploit Obama's lack of American roots. And they actually went out and accused Obama. You know, they blasted him for suggesting the photo of him in Somali garb was why would you say this is controversial photo, Obama? How dare you? So they turned it around on him. So you have to understand what's happening there. This is Saul Alinsky 101. He's a favored Luciferian of the left. And this is why Trump is going to win this. As you see, top forecasters say it's not over yet. Don't get too comfortable, Hillary Clinton, because Donald Trump will win.
On November 8th, the arrogance of Washington, D.C. will come face to face with the righteous verdict of the American voter. It's about time.
The party of Lincoln has become the party of Trump.
Americanism, not globalism, will be our credo. Americanism, not globalism. Americanism, not globalism.
We'll be right back.